Checking my vital signs, on my battle lines, going to war again. Feeling the rhythm inside of my chest, all I need is just a pen. I know I was born for this. I know I was born for this. Well, welcome everyone to the 10th episode of the podcast, The Bamboo Lab. Welcome to your Monday. Welcome to your week. I'm your host, Brian Bosey. And for the past quarter century, I've had the most amazing pleasure of coaching some amazing top performers and peak performers around the world. And here in this podcast, what we're doing is we're bringing these ideas and these strategies directly to you. Those ideas and strategies that got these individuals to where they are today. This podcast is created and broadcast just for you, all you strivers, thrivers, and survivors out there. Do you feel that you're a little bit underachieving in your life right now? Are you stuck on that hamster wheel of life and you're spinning, but you're just not moving forward, man, and you're just ready to jump off and advance forward? Do you know deep down in your soul that you just have a lot more to give to your own life? And to the life of your loved ones, and maybe to the entire world as a whole. If so, well, then you landed at the right place, man. This is for you. This is your Bamboo Lab. You know, I had a nice email this week, or a text, I think it was actually, from a listener, and he said, I really love your content. You've gotten better every week. And he said, what I like about it is this material could be extremely preachy, but you don't come across that way. And here's why. I've been all those people. I've been the underachiever. I've been on the hamster wheel. And I've known many times in my life, most of my life, that I have more to give to myself and to my loved ones and to the world at large. So I'm just sharing the stuff I've gone through and what I've learned along the way. If any of you listeners would like to learn more about what we do here at the Bamboo Lab, feel free to email me. My email is Brian with an I at bamboolab3.com. That's Brian at bamboolab3.com. Today, I want to recognize three new listeners out there. There are a lot of new ones, and I'll share some numbers here in a minute. But three ones that I wanted to randomly pull out this week, and one of them is Cassie T. out of Chesaning, Michigan. I appreciate the kind words, Cassie, and I'll continue to try my best to deliver better material each week. And Todd O. out of Kansas. Welcome and thank you, Todd. And AJ out of Ohio. Welcome aboard, AJ. I like to read a text or a letter every week from a listener that I got that really meant something to me. But this was one that I actually heard face-to-face, which was really cool. This week was my 55th birthday, and I was surrounded by, I mean, not everybody I loved was here, but everybody here I loved and deeply and intensely. And a good family friend by the name of Blanche said to me, I'm going to paraphrase a little bit because I didn't get a direct quote, but I think I'm fairly accurate. And if I'm not, Blanche, you can text me, call me, or email me and chew me out. But she said, I've never really listened to podcasts before, but I do so every night on Monday nights. And she said, it's really changed my life. She might not even known, but that might have been one of the greatest birthday gifts I ever received over the weekend. So Blanche, thank you for tuning in each week, and thank you for the kind words and the encouragement. I'll continue to strive each week to give material that changes lives, just like yourself. I wanted to share some statistics today because we were happily surprised late last week with looking at the outreach of the Bamboo Lab so far, and I was pretty surprised. I got to be honest with you. I mean, I'm humbled by it, but happily humbled. So as of this afternoon, we updated the statistics or the data this afternoon. And so far in the first, 2.5 months, we are in 208 cities across the country, 25 states and 12 different countries. And three new countries we want to welcome this week are France, Brazil, and Denmark. Welcome aboard. It's just great to see that it's reaching other parts of the world because this material is universal. It's not just for, you know, U.S. citizens, man. This stuff can be worked anywhere in any remote reaches and segments of our planet here. So this particular episode is dedicated to a man that I've had the pleasure of working with over the past couple of years. Tyler S. out of Okemos, Michigan. I'm going to dedicate this to you, my friend. Tyler has been challenged with cerebral palsy, CP, since birth, and now he's in his 20s. And this guy, man, he epitomizes grit and strength and positivity and exudes it when you talk to him. And he has done such a great job of not just taking this challenge in making a decent life for himself. He has taken this challenge and made an incredible life, a journey, an inspiration for himself and for others, to the point now where he started an endowment at his college, Concordia University, to help other people who are challenged at a young age. He's now looking at material that he wants to spread to the world, and he's putting together some really cool content. And he made a really cool statement to me in the last few days. He talked about embracing your limp. You know, if you got a limp in life, whether it's physical, emotional, intellectual, spiritual, something that seems like it's a hindrance, embrace it. And make it your strength. So, Tyler, this goes out to you, my friend. And this goes out to all those Tylers in each of us. Each of us suffers, challenged by, has, you know, those brick walls in front of us that some of us stop and turn around and go back, and we regret it the rest of our lives. Others take that brick wall, and we use it to prove to ourselves how badly we want to scale it. But before we get started today, I want to wish an amazing happy birthday to our little Peeler. Happy 12th birthday this Saturday, honey. You are one of the most amazing 12-year-olds I have ever had the pleasure to meet, and it's going to be an honor to see you turn 12 this weekend. Happy birthday, sweetie. All right. I had a really good quote this week that fit into the material we talked about last week, and then we will continue this week. And Kelly shared this quote with me that she found. It said, and this is a quote, "Love all, trust few. Everything's real, but not everyone's true." So as you know, man, that fits in perfectly to our conversation we've had regarding food and poison over the past, starting last week and continue on this week. And I'm going to go through a little replay of last week and share some of the things we talked about. So the idea is, and it's not even an idea, it's a natural law. This is a natural law. You know, you maybe the healthiest you've ever been in your life right now physically, but if you drink a thimble full of poison, you're going to die or you're going to get gravely ill. We understand that concept as it pertains to our physical and our physiological being. We know that poison kills. We oftentimes forget that when it comes to our spiritual, our emotional, our intellectual, or even the physical space we inhabit, if we allow poison into that, it's going to erode us. It's going to conquer us. It's going to take us, and it's going to kill us. So we're talking about respecting the laws of food and poison. And I started last week with a quote that I'm going to share again by Ayn Rand, the philosopher that came over from Russia and loved the idea of capitalism and rational self-interest. She said, "In any compromise between food and poison, it is only death that can win. In any compromise between good and evil, it is only evil that can profit." Very simple. You allow people who have a toxic or poisonous mentality and behavior into your world, they're going to win. That toxicity will take over because toxicity is not honest and straightforward. So therefore, you don't see it coming at you. It's like a corrosive gas, man. It weaves into your world, into your existence. And before you know it, before you can even know it, you're aware of it, it's got a hold of you. But also, we can't just talk about the toxicity of other people. We have to dissect and we have to give ourselves a good audit and ask ourselves, do we allow toxicity into other people's world? Do we bring toxicity into our own space? And I mentioned last week, you know, I hear so often from individuals, you know, "Brian, what is that number one thing that can cause success or failure in the world?" And it's very simple. It's what you do and what you tolerate from others. What you do and what you tolerate is the impetus and the determining factor between success or failure in your existence. And success or failure can mean many things. It can mean financial success or failure, emotional. We can be talking about your love life, your happiness, your health. It's numerous. However you define success and however you define failure, what you allow into your world, whether it comes from you or what you tolerate from others, will determine that. So I think last week we talked about what's the difference between a food style person and a poisonous style person, or food style behavior in ourselves and poisonous behaviors in ourselves. We went through six of those, and I'll recap them real quickly. First one, food style people have active minds. Poisonous people do not, because they're petty and whiny. Number two, food style people have and they live by some set of guiding principles, where poisonous people, they might have them, some guiding principles, but they seldom live by them. Number three, food style people are independent. They know that truth is a numbers game, that they can stand alone on an issue and still be confident that they're right. Where poisonous people are so dependent upon others' opinions and weaknesses, they are a true parasite. Number four is food style people have no time or tolerance for gossip, where poisonous people are completely wrapped up in gossip. They love to talk about the person who's not in the room. Number five, we talked about the windshield and the bug. And as I mentioned last week, this is one of my favorite ones. In life, we are either the windshield and we're going down the highway of life and everything's going well. Some days we're the bug. We're getting splattered by the windshield. When you are splattered by the windshield, how do you react? When you're having that bad day, that bad week, that bad month, that bad quarter, just in a bad phase of life, how do you react? Because when that happens to food style people, they look inwardly and they say, how can I change my own behavior and patterns and habits? Or a poisonous person, they'll look outside and say, I want you to change. They'll try to get you to change or other people to change their behaviors so that they can feel better. And I think that's where, I think we wrapped up with number six, which was food style people are engaged in reality. They see reality. A to them is A. A is not B. It's not C. They see truth. Where poisonous people are engaged in self-deception. They like to trick themselves into thinking what they're doing is the right thing, when in deep down they know it's not. So we went through those six attributes. So what we're trying to do here today is, you know, when you're looking at your own behavior or the behavior of others, so often determining food or poison is instinctive. You know when you are with somebody if they're fakey or not. You know if a person is good for you or bad for you. You might not want to admit it, but usually you know. And we also know instinctively how we're behaving. We try to hide it all the time. We all do. We all do this. We do things that we know are self-destructive to ourselves or others. But when we look at these examples here, we can say, now I know why that person is food or that person is poison. Or I know why I can be food or where I'm poison in my life or the life of others. Because here are the specific examples that separate the two. So let's jump into number seven here. All right. Food style people make their decisions on logical, rational thought. They look at cause and effect. They look and say, okay, if I do this, what's going to happen? They can look at why things are happening and go back to, okay, here's the cause of it, and they can make changes. Or they can look and say, if I keep going down this path, here's what's probably going to happen. Poisonous people don't do it that way. They make their decisions primarily on emotional, subjective thought. You watch TV and you see these people screaming because somebody they don't agree with is speaking on campus, and they're outside screaming at the top of their lungs. Emotional, subjective reaction. See, you know, we human beings we have a lot of separations between us and the animal world. We do. But the number one thing, and for all of you deer hunters out there, you'll get this. Animals react primarily on instinct. If you're a hunter and you see your going for, your bird or your deer or your moose, and you make the wrong move, that animal usually doesn't stop and think rationally. They instinctively run off. We humans have the ability to do something different. When we have a stimulus in our life that we don't quite get, or that feels uncomfortable or new, we can pause before we react. Stimulus, pause, reaction. And it's that pause that keeps us humans on this side of the zoo cage. If you take that away, we're nothing better than animals. We're running on instinct. And the instinct is nothing more than subjective emotional thought. So when we see somebody having those emotional outbreaks, I mean, we're talking adults. Children have them all the time as they learn and grow. But an adult who has those, you can tell, I always think to myself, that person's much closer to an animal than the person over here who's pausing and looking at things from a rational position. Food or poison? Rational or emotional? Number eight, man, I really like this one too. This is one of my favorites as well. Food style people believe that the most challenging aspect of their life or job brings out the very best in them. Where poisonous people believe that the most challenging aspect of their life or job brings out the worst in them. So think about that part of your life that you just don't like doing, but you know it's necessary. Maybe you're a new parent, and it's like getting up at three or four times in the middle of the night to feed or change diapers. Or maybe you're part of your job that you just, the meetings that you sit through that are necessary, but you just despise them. For me, it's role-playing speeches. I give a lot of speeches, and I have over the past 25 years. I love to speak in public. I despise role-playing in my office or my house by myself. I'll sometimes set up a bust of Beethoven I have and a bust of a pharaoh. Sometimes my dog, I'll look at those like they're the audience. I despise every minute of role playing. But I understand that that brings out the best in me. So think about that part of your job or your life that's so challenging, whether it's cold calling your prospects, whether it's sweeping the floor of your store, whether it's, you know, getting up at 3 a.m. for some reason to take care of a sick child. Just think about whether you look at those parts of your job that are necessary but extremely challenging. Do you look at them and say, huh, this is awful. I wish I didn't have to do this. This makes me a lesser person. Or do you look at these things and say, huh, I don't like this, but you know what? I'm blessed that I'm able to do it, and I know that it brings out the best in me. It makes me a better human because I'm doing this. It makes me stronger, wiser, more understanding, and empathetic. That right there is the one of the top attributes or the determining factors that I see in people. Because, again, go back to the first attribute, active mind or petty and whiny, which is the first one we talked about last week and mentioned today. When you look at a challenging aspect of your life and you look at it and say, this is, I don't like it, but it's bringing out the best of me because I'm really going at, I'm leaning into it. That means you have an active mind. But if you look at something that you're doing, you have to do, and you look at it and say, but you know, it's good, but it's challenging. And you say, oh, I hate doing this. I wish I didn't have to do that. That's petty and whiny. So those two fit in very well together. Number eight, do you look at life, the hard things, the challenging things, and say, I'm a better person for it? Or do you look at those things and say, this makes me a lesser person? Food or poison? Number nine, food style people are courageous. And I don't just mean courageous like we see in the silver screen or read about in books, but I'm talking about real, true courage, where you can stand on an issue alone. You can live the life you were designed to live. You can do you, boo. You can stand up for other people who are disenfranchised. That's what a food style person is. They're courageous. They've got raw courage. Where poisonous people are the biggest cowards. And one of the ways you can see cowardice is in how people seek counsel in their world. Where a courageous person, a food style person, will go around and ask people advice, or they'll share mistakes they've made. But they won't go to people just because they know that person will agree with them. They'll go to people who challenge them. They want to be challenged, man. They want to grow. They want to be pushed to the limit. They want feedback and criticism. Poisonous people don't do that. They're such cowards. They answer shop. They go out there and seek people who will give them the answers they're looking for instead of looking and seeking the answers that will challenge their thinking. We see this every day in our country today. And all the mass media takes advantage of this. We are so polarized because if you are one side of the equation politically, you're only going to watch certain news outlets. If you're on the other side, you're only going to watch other certain news outlets. You are out there trying to get advice and information from people who you know agree with you. It's called confirmation bias. And I think right now it's the one thing that's keeping our country so polarized. Get out there. Talk to people who don't agree with you. Let them challenge you. Let them turn you in. Maybe a little light switch will go on. Maybe you'll learn something you didn't know. It's so difficult. This might be the most difficult of all of them. But it pervades across our country. And I think our country needs more courage and courageous people and less cowardly people. And this could be the ticket. Be okay being challenged. Number 10, food style people show gratitude. They do. They get up in the morning and they look for things that make them, that they're grateful for. What do you appreciate? And our, you know, as human beings right now, our brains are so designed, and I shared this before, our brains are so designed to look for the negative in life, in other people, in ourselves, and in situations, and because it protects it. That's what protects us. You know, our amygdalas are a little part of our brain shaped like an almond, small, but it really is designed to keep threats away. So it's so powerful that now that we don't have all these threats that we had in the, you know, when we were, you know, 10,000 years ago, 80,000 years ago, we don't have those threats. There are no saber-toothed cats. There are no giant grizzlies that most of us have to face or tidal waves. We don't have that. But our brain is still there. The amygdala is still there trying to protect us. So our brain sees things. So for every positive thing you notice during the course of your day, you see 9 negative things. Those are bad odds, man. 9 to 1, negative to positive. It's really difficult to run your car on bad gas. And that's what we're doing. So good exercise, get up in the morning, grab a piece of paper, a journal, and every morning write down 3 things that you are grateful for at that moment. Be specific. Don't just say family, health, and happiness. Be specific on something that you right now can be your dog curled up next to you while you're drinking your coffee. It could be the fact that you watched a movie with your son last night and had a little conversation about it. It could be the fact that so many loved ones came to your house over the weekend and celebrated your 55th birthday. And you know who you are, all of you, and I thank you. When you do that, your mind starts to see more of the positive in life. And there are so many more positive things than there are negative. Train your brain to see those things. Because that's what food style people, they show gratitude. Not poisonous people. Hell no. Poisonous people are thankful to nobody in this world. They expect things. They see the negative in life, and the negative in themselves, and the negative in others. And you can see it on their face. They have that scowl. It looks like they're smelling crap all day. They have that little, what they call resting bee face. They just look like the world is after them, and they expect everybody else to make changes. When they really, all they have to do is open their eyes and realize there are 10,000 positive things in your world to every negative, but we're seeing 9 negative to every positive. Retrain your brain. So gratitude or thanklessness, food or poison. And the last one here, number 12 or number 11, I believe it is. Food style people are students of life. They are. They learn. They grow. They dissect things. They question things. They allow themselves to be challenged. They sit through podcasts just like the Bamboo Lab here. They want to learn, man. They want to become a better human being. Poisonous people, no chance they're students of life. You know why? They already know everything. Because they don't allow themselves to be challenged. They don't pick up a book and learn. They don't try to understand other viewpoints or perspectives. Remember this quote, only fools and dead people refuse to change their minds. Student of life? Or is your mind closed? I already know everything. Food or poison? As we wrap these up today, which ones did you relate to most? Which area do you see the most in the people you hang with? Who are the food people in your life? Who are the poison people in your life? Where are you food in your own life and the lives of others? Where are you toxic and poisonous? What we need to do in this world, again, is make the unacceptable unacceptable in our own behavior, in the things we do, and also in what we tolerate in our world. I'm going to wrap this up with a story that I love. It's the story of two wolves. Well, more than that, it's a story of a grandpa and his grandson. And the grandfather is telling this young boy, I want to share with you, little pal, that in your soul and in your mind and in your heart, there are two wolves. And one wolf is strong and courageous and honorable and kind and understanding and empathetic and positive and nourishing. The other wolf is decrepit. It's mean. It's deceptive. It's negative. It's out to destroy. It has no honor, no courage, but yet it's extremely powerful. It's as powerful as the other wolf. And little pal, every moment of your life, those two wolves are fighting. They're fighting inside you. They're fighting for dominance to take over you. Every single moment, every decision you make, everything you do, and everything you tolerate is giving strength to one of those wolves. And it determines your life, your current and your future. And it determines the direction of the people around you. And they fight and they fight and they fight every single moment. The grandson's eyes get a little wide, maybe a little scared at this abrupt message. And he says, well, Grandpa, if they're always fighting and they're both strong and one's good and one is evil, which one will eventually win? And the grandpa was waiting for that question because he had the answer. And he bent down, got on his one knee, looked his grandson right in the eye, and he said, whichever one you feed, whichever wolf you feed. So it pertains to what you do and what you tolerate in life, your success or your failure, your health, your lack of health, your happiness or your unhappiness, your love or lack of love, or whatever it is in life. The wolf you feed, the food style nourishing wolf, or the poisonous toxic wolf, determines everything. I want to take this time again to thank all of you. It's a distinct pleasure to spend every Monday afternoon with you. I'm humbled. I'm appreciative of each one of you current listeners, your returning listeners, and all of you new listeners out there. Please reach out to me, brian@bambolab3.com. I will get back with you. Give me feedback. Tell me what we're doing well. Tell me what we need to change. And I'll do it. If it makes sense, I'll do it. But in the meantime, let's get out there. Let's sculpt our lives. Let's sculpt the world. Let's make it a better place. Let's get rid of all the garbage that's wrapped around us. Get back to the core element of what it's like to be a true human being. In the meantime, this week, God bless you all. God bless your friends. God bless your families. And by all means, man, God bless your dreams.
Physics are force that they can't stop. They just don't get it. I think they forget I'm not done till I'm on top. I know.